The back end down.
It's sticking.
Okay. Now, run it over.
Okay. And basically, that's a little bit long, so you're going to just take, you're going to make your little loop.
Take half?
You could take a little more than half. There you go. Right there, well. So, and then you're going to make
that
little
part,
figure eight.
That goes back in your bag.
And you do it on the side a little bit so that it stands up.
Is this going to need help, or will it just
pull
apart?
It
probably need
package,
a little bit of help.
Christmas package for Christmas.
Okay. That's why I said push hard.
That one end went down okay, but I don't know what happened.
Okay.
All right. You can separate all those, and then she'll
and
show you and Jeannie how to do it.
I put a little loop. I took one of the pieces and made a little loop for the center.
So I should put this on first, right?
Yeah, put that on first. Now you want to put it where
your lath is, right there. Now that other cutter that you're talking about will cut your fondant nicely. It's just not going to make even strips for you. This saves an awful lot of time.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're having a lot of problems,
you make the figure eight first, right?
Yes, you're gonna make. I'm actually gonna do another one.
Oh, she's gonna do it with you.
Yeah, it likes to stick when you stir it off sometimes. Mm-hmm. Let's get this off of there. Glad we're having troubles, technical issues here.
That's why you have edit on the button.
There you go. See? And here's your bow. And then you could just take and make your little figure eight, like that. Pinch it a little bit in the center, make sure it's even. Now that's all ready to be put on the cake. You could put it right on your little cake there. And then you can take a little piece of this if you want to pinch it off and then make your little center of your bow. And of course, don't forget to put the water, your glue, right there. And then stick that piece there.
So this I'm cutting, making it shorter.
Right in the center.
No.
Put your glasses on so you can see.
Almost on the side.
And you can use the back end of your paintbrush or your fondant tool to get that in place. And then the remainder will be for your ribbon.
It depends on how puffy you want.
But basically, you're starting off with that little bit of ruffle there.
A
little bit of figure eight, I should say. And that would be the end of that when you put it on your cake.
And then to actually decide where on here you want the ribbon.
Okay. You're making it, you don't need it that long, Frank.
I noticed it's sticking to me.
Yeah.